So hello guys, and as was said, I will be talking about automation of rebasing of RPM packages with rebase-helper. So just a question of curiosity, who here maintains a package, an RPM package or whatever? Okay, that's nice to see a lot of you. So you probably know that rebasing your packages is quite a demanding task. It can take a long time, there are many steps that you have to do, and it can often fail, which results in you having to do these tasks and steps again. So the goal of rebase-helper is to automate these tasks as much as possible, and if these tasks cannot be automated, the goal is to provide information and provide assistance to the maintainer so he can do the rebase correctly. Rebase-helper operates on a directory with a spec file. The directory can also contain patches and sources. So this would typically be your clone disk git repository. And as I said, it can do automatically many things, which I will show you in the demo. It has many command line options, so you can basically influence the whole rebase process. So you can change, for example, the build tool that is used to create RPM or source RPM. I will show more of these later. And also, rebase-helper is packaged in Fedora, so you can easily install it, and it can also be run in a container for those container enthusiasts. And, well, because I think that examples are better than plain words, and instead of just talking about what rebase-helper can actually do, I am going to try to show you what it can actually do. And if anyone was interested, there is the list of packages that I'm going to show you the rebases of, so you can later try it out. Just a quick note before I start, some of these rebases take a long time because there are long builds, so I'm going to show the most important steps and then just skip the build and show you the result. Okay, so as the first package, I've prepared a simple one, which is called libpipeline. And basically, it is just a simple package. We can have a look at the spec file. There is just a simple preamble, and the build process is quite simple. So rebasing of the package should be quite a simple task. It should be just a matter of bumping the version and then adding a changelog entry. So there are no patches, as you could have seen, and this git repo is very simple. So let's just run rebase-helper now and see what happens. Because I ran rebase-helper without any argument, it automatically tries to... Oh, I'm not connected to the Wi-Fi, so I have to log in. Oh, nice. It's too short, so I'm going to log in. It's going to be faster. DevConf.CZ and developers 2020. Developers 2020. Okay. So I'm going to restart it, and because I didn't provide any arguments, is it working? Yes, it is. Okay, it's running. So I didn't provide any argument, so it ran a version here to determine the latest upstream version, which it is going to rebase to. So in this case, it determined the latest upstream version to be 1.5.2. There are many more tools aside from Anitia, so it can also fetch the latest upstream version from PyPy or NPM. And as you can see, then it ran spec hooks. Those are special tools that modify the spec file so that the build can pass. For example, we can see replace old version, which basically aims to replace hard-coded parts of the old version to the new version, or replace it with a version macro so the builds can pass, because without replacing it, for example, in the source, it obviously wouldn't work correctly. Then sources are downloaded, so you can see it started downloading sources. This is the old source, so it is downloaded from Lucas side cache, and then the new source is downloaded from the source 0 URL. Then license check is run to check for license changes. You can obviously disable this check, and there are many more checks. I will talk about them a bit later. So this is going to take some time. I think it will be in a second finished, so just give it a moment. Okay, and now, as you can see, git rebase operation started. Because there weren't any patches, so there was basically nothing to do. In the process, the sources are extracted. So first, old version sources are extracted, then new version sources are extracted, and the patches are applied to the old sources. Then git rebase is used to rebase the commits onto the new version. And as you could see in the spec file, there were no patches, so basically there is nothing that could go wrong with the rebase. And then source RPMs are built, first the old one, then the new one, and the same goes for new RPMs. By default, Rebase Helper builds the packages using mock, so this is what I'm using here. But as I said, you could also use RPM build, or you could use some of the remote build tools, such as Koji or Copper. This is going to finish in a bit, so let's just give it a moment. Well, while we are waiting, I'm going to... There is a question. So the question was, is it built in locally in the repository, or what did you mean exactly?
I
Okay, so it creates a workspace directory in which it builds the packages. It uses the, as you could see, it fetched the sources, and then it just used mock to build the packages. So. Okay, so then the build finished successfully, so it could go to checks, so an ABI package diff, RPN diff, and so name check. And then there is a short summary of the whole rebase, where you can find information about, where you can find basically more information about the rebase. So let's have a look at what Rebase Helper produced. So we can see that the sources were downloaded, we can see the two tarballs. And then there's the Rebase Helper results directory, which contains all the results. So let's have a look at it. And there's the report txt. The report contains the whole summary, what happened, so we can see if there were any ABI changes, it would be listed here. If there were any patches, it would also be here. And there are also lists of files created, etc., etc. You could also create the report as JSON so that you could further process it. Then there is the changes.patch, which contains the patch of the repo that you can apply. So we can see that in this case, as I said, it was just a case of simply bumping the version, changing the release, and adding a new changelog entry. In other cases, there could be some more modifications to the spec file or to the patches, but in this case, there were no patches, so we have nothing to worry about. Then there is the Rebase Sources repository, which, as the name suggests, contains Rebase Sources. So this is basically the copy of this Git repository, and modifications are done here. So the patch is then generated between the original Git repository and this Rebase Sources repository. Then there are the old build and new build directories, which contain the build data. So there are the created RPMs, source RPMs, and also the logs. And then there are checkers. So as I showed, a suite of checks is ran, which aim to help you determine whether the rebase went correctly and whether there are any errors in the packages. So we can have a look, for example, at package diff. There is the full output of the package diff runtime. So we can have a look at, for example, the report. So there is a list of the changes. Okay, so this was it for the initial rebase, where I just showed you what the Rebase Helper produces and how it works. So let's now get to a more difficult rebase. So this is going to be rebase of libjpeg turbo. Let's have a look at the spec file. As you can see, there are already some patches. So in the spec file, they are also listed. And let's have a look at prep. We can see that they are applied normally without auto setup. So let's run Rebase Helper here. This time I'm going to specify the version, so I can just put it in as the argument. This is going to be 202, and it's going to rebase to this version. You could also provide a tarball for the version. So, yes. Okay, the Wi-Fi is quite slow, so it may take some time. I just hope it finishes quite quickly. Or perhaps to speed things up, I've already prepared those download sources so I can have a look at that. So let's go here. And I will run it once again. When the sources are already present, rebase-helper doesn't re-download them because that would be pointless. And also this time I'm going to disable some of the checks to make it a bit quicker, so I'm going to just run package diff. Okay, so as you can see, vimdiff came up because there was a merge conflict during the git rebase operation. So rebase helper used git merge tool to bring up the merge tool. This is quite a simple conflict, so let's have a look. There's just one problem, so I'm going to fix it. And that should be all. Yes, that's all. So let's close it. And let's have a look at the output. So we can see that all of the patches were applied to the old sources in the order that they were given. And then rebase helper used git rebase to rebase the commits. And as you can see, it failed to auto-merge the patch and a merge conflict occurred. And we can see that rebase helper asks us if we want to continue. If there were any unedited hunks that were still left to solve, it would also warn us so we could continue with fixing the merge conflict. So let's continue for now. And rebase helper is going to be building. I hope just that it's going to finish quite quickly. In the meantime, I can show something else and get back to this a bit later, I hope. So let's jump out and I'm going to show you another result because this is just one rebase of the package. And let's have a look at the other one. I did two of them. This one was from version 203 to 204. And something interesting other than a merge conflict occurred. So it was an auto merge. Let's have a look at the result and changes specifically. So we can see that there are some changes in the patches because the sources changed and the lines have to be altered as well because, well, it would otherwise the patch wouldn't correspond correctly. This is just an advantage of using Git for this. I just hope, it hasn't finished yet. The problem here is that I had prepared the results, but I overwrote it because I used the downloaded sources due to the slow Wi-Fi, and my rebase helper results directory that I had prepared had been overridden by new one. So I think this is going to finish in a few minutes. So I'm going to just let it run and show you the results a bit later. But for now, I'm going to show another example which I have prepared, and that is rebasing of example package. No, this is not the one. Okay, so this is the example package. As you can see, the build went correctly. We can see that the new RPMs finished successfully and the checks were run. And rebase helper warns us that there are some name changes because there is obviously a problem for a new packing for a rebase. If some name changes occur, the maintainer should be warned. So let's have a look at a more detailed output to see what's happening. We can have a look at the report to get a better idea. And we can see that in the package exempy, soname changed from libexempy SO3 to libexempy SO8. So the maintainer could act on this, report it, and he's aware, so that is a good thing. We could also have a look at the output of checkers here. So ABI package diff was ran. If you were interested, we could have a look at the report of ABI, but there are obviously no ABI changes, so nothing really wrong, except for the SO name change. And this isn't finished yet, but the new build is already on the way, so it should be fairly soon. And let's jump into another example. Okay, it's running package diff, so I will just finish one more example and then get back to the rebase with merge conflict. Okay, so in this example, you can see that the new build failed, but we implemented build log analyzers that aim to try to fix trivial problems and change the spec file so that the build passes. So in this case, it was an error of files section, so there were some files missing, and rebase helper determined this and edit the files, so we can see that a lot of files were added. Obviously, in this case, the maintainer would probably have to modify it because you can see that the pass could be somehow made easier using wildcards. So there are a lot of paths added. But in the end, let's jump down a bit. You can see that I restarted the build, and it built the RPMs again, and then the build passed. So let's have a look at the diff. And if you look at the patch, a lot of files were added to the spec file, which obviously the maintainer would manually have to check whether that is correct. But the build passed, and that's a good thing, obviously. So let's now get back to the rebase with merge conflict. As you can see, rebase helper informed us here that there's a patch modified, and also that that some patches were deleted. We can have a look at the results. It is also mentioned in the report, so there is a short legend, and we can see two patches were deleted, one patch was modified. If we now have a look at changes, there are the two deleted patches. This is the first one, this is the second one, and then there are the changes in the spec file. This is the modified one, and then there is the spec file, so we can see again version bump, release update, and these two patches were removed, and they were also removed from the perp section and change log entry edit. Okay, so now let's have a look at some other options. So the package maintainers here in the audience have probably seen bugzars like these, where it tells you that there is a new upstream release of a package. So I just picked a random one that is quite recent. And you would obviously, if you don't have the disk git cloned already, you would have to clone it yourself. So we decided to implement a feature, so you can just copy the ID. And now let's jump a bit up. And we can launch Rebase Helper with the option Bugzilla ID, and just use the ID from the Bugzilla. It is going to automatically determine what is the package, and it's going to clone the repository, and then it's going to determine the latest version from the comments. So if we jump down, we can see the latest upstream version 3.7.6, so it's going to read it from here, and it's going to rebase to the version. The building would take a long time, so I'm just going to cancel it for now. And well, as I said, there are a lot more options to rebase helper, so I'm just going to show you the help and explain some of the basic options. So for example, we can see that you can specify which checks you want to run, or you can change the output tool so that you can have your JSON output and further process it if you wanted to create a wrapper script on the rebase helper. And you could also specify the version here which you want to use, or maybe another interesting one are the build tools, so that you can use, you can see that there are four build tools supported and two source RPM build tools supported. Another interesting option is non-interactive, so that basically means that there are going to be no dialogues with the user, so it is just going to run and do its thing. Obviously, it is not 100% reliable because there are just some tasks that the maintainer has to do. So for example, merge conflicts can easily be resolved. So for example, with merge conflicts, you can specify merge strategy that can help possibly, but it can have some drawbacks, so it may not work perfectly. And well, I think that's almost all for now from me. So now we have, I think, 5 minutes for the questions. Hmm?
So is there a way that I can skip downloading the sources from the disk types? So that I don't want to see all the differences, only I'm interested in the spec file differences and if there are any much conflicts.
So the question was whether there is a way to skip downloading the sources, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm. I mean the older sources.
Yes, there is a way. If you have already the sources in your disk repository, or if you have already, for example, from previous builds, then Rebase Helper won't download them.
For example, if I want to build a package for different Fedora versions, how can I do it? Do you have plans with the build not a local machine, but within some containers, so you can specify like an image, like Fedora 29, 61, 30, and build within container, not
Okay, so the question was whether you can build in a container, which I've already mentioned. It is described in the documentation. You can run rebase-helper in a container, and you can also specify the Fedora version, so it should be quite usable for the use case you mentioned. Okay, so the question is when we will start running rebase-helper as a service. And well, it is planned, obviously, but we first want to make sure that rebase-helper works correctly when it is used offline, because some of the maintainers who, for example, saw the talk 3 years ago about rebase-helper, so it was already deployed to upstream release monitoring service, and it wasn't very reliable, so it made a lot of mess. So we'd rather avoid it and make it a bit more stable. But it is coming soon, I hope. Okay.
Is it accessible in CentOS?
Okay, so the question was whether rebase-helper is accessible in CentOS. And I don't think so. There is a package in Apple, but I'm not really positive what the version is in Apple. But you should be able to build it or maybe download the latest sources. It should work without a problem.
Extending to the question of service, any chances of tying this up to Fed package?
So the question was whether it is going to be tied to Fed package. We'll see. Not very sure. I think it's quite a new project, or it has been running for a long time. But we first want to optimize it so it is very reliable. Mm-hmm. Could you please repeat it?
I noticed that as part of the report, you were running RPM Div. Are there any plans to integrate RPM Inspect instead of RPM Div?
So the question was whether we are planning to implement RPM Inspect instead of RPM Div. The thing is, with these checks, it can be quite easily extended. They are implemented as plugins, so even the user can program his own plugin, so it can run, for example, the RPM Inspect. So we can implement it. For example, you can create an issue on GitHub, and we will be happy to implement it and at RPM spec. So here is the QR code of our GitHub repo if you are interested, and you can add an issue, and we will look into it.
Is there any way to merge downstream and upstream specs?
Okay, so the question was whether there is a way to merge upstream and downstream specs. And I don't think there is a reliable way, or at least not implemented in rebase-helper.
Or at least can we make the merge manually and then use automatic rebase?
Well, that should be possible. Okay.
There are no patches in the spec file. Can you skip downloading the old sources archive? Because
Okay, so the question was whether there is a way to skip downloading all sources spec file if there are no patches. And I don't think it's currently supported, but that is a good point, and we will try to implement it because I think that could be nice if the source gets big. I don't think there is a point in downloading two of the sources. Any other questions? So thank you guys for your attention, and if you have any more questions, you can reach us these ways.